Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for TEAS. We have been solving TEAS math problems out of this book here, the TEAS Study Guide, version 7, 2025. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Always make sure that this book is in front of you when we are working together. Today is our lesson number 22. We are on page number 112. There are five practice problems that you see there on page 112. We did problem number 2 yesterday by itself, and today we'll do the remaining 4. Let's begin with problem number 1. Problem number 1, as you can see, is already on the blackboard, and this is the question. The question is, we are given this quantity, 346.8 times 5.231 divided by 49.6, and we are being asked to give the best estimate. And I also wrote down the answer choices so that you can understand why the right answer is the right answer and why, even more importantly, why the wrong answers are wrong. You have to understand why the correct answer is correct, but we also have to understand, even more important in my opinion, is understanding why the given answer was wrong. Let's begin, shall we? So let's start with the answer choices. So what did they do here? 346.8. And what did they do here? Well, they just dropped the 0.8. They just dropped it for no reason. If you are rounding it to the nearest unit digit is right here. If you are rounding it to the nearest unit digit, because it is 0.8, is more than 5, it should have been rounded to the nearest unit digit. It should have become 347. You can't just drop the bloody thing because you don't like it. You can't just drop it just because you don't like it. There are many more things wrong with it. Similarly here, 5.231, if you were rounding it to the nearest unit digit, then because 5.2 is less than 5.5, if you were rounding it to the nearest unit digit, it would have become 5. If you were rounding it to the nearest tenth digit, is right here, this is the tenth digit. If you were rounding it to the nearest tenth digit, because this is only 3, it's less than 5, if you are rounding it to the nearest tenth digit, it will become 5.2. How does it become 6? It's just nonsense. And same thing here. They did the same exact thing here. They didn't like the 0.6 business, so they said, why don't we just ignore it? You can't do that. The exam is not, the purpose of the exam is not to show these people the full extent of your insanity. That's not what we're here, to show them how insane we are. Okay. So that's why it's wrong. This is just nonsense. What's wrong with this one? Well, the first number is 300. If 346.8, if you're being asked to round it to nearest 100, then it will go from 300 to 400. Half your mark would be 350, and this is less than 350. So if you're rounding this to nearest 300, then it would become 300. But then how does the 5.23 become just 5? You're rounding this guy to nearest 10 digits. And again, this guy, 49.16, they're rounding it to nearest unit digit, ones digit rather. They're rounding this to ones digit, they're rounding this to ones digit, but they're rounding this one to nearest hundreds digit. These two, 5.23, when rounded to nearest unit digit, will become 5. 49.6 will become 50 when you're rounding it to nearest unit digit. This is being rounded to nearest unit digit. This is being rounded to nearest unit digit. But for some strange and inexplicable reason, this thing is being rounded to nearest hundreds. You can't do that. You have to be consistent. And same insanity is going on here that happened here. For some strange reason, they decided to ignore the 0.6. If you're rounding it to nearest unit digit, it would have become 50. Just like this guy, when he's rounded to nearest unit digit, it would become 5, but then again, when you're rounding this to a unit digit, it should have become 347. For some strange reason, it's 350. Let's start again then. So if you're going to round this thing to the nearest unit digit is right here. If you're going to round it to nearest unit digit, then we have to look at the one that comes after it. It's 8, because 8 is more than 5. 347.8 will become 347. There you go. Same thing, 5.231, if you're rounding it to the nearest unit digit, the unit digit is here. What comes after it is 2, Since 2 is less than 5, 5.23 when rounded to nearest unit digit will become 5. Same thing with 49.6 when rounded to nearest unit digit will become 50. This is the right answer. Let's do next one. There was a lot of very disturbing madness in that, in those wrong answers. Number 3, we did the number 2 already, as I told you. Number 3, they are simply asking us that we're going to measure the length of a paper clip. And the first question is, so the question here is, should we use a meter, which of the following metric best represents the length of a meter? Would a meter be used to measure the length of a clip? The answer is only if you're off your rocker, because a meter is almost equal to a yard. Meter is about 39 inches and yard is 36 inches. As you can see, they're almost the same. You're not going to measure the length of a clip in terms of yards, and you're going to probably tell me this clip is so many yards long. It's too tiny to be measured in yards. A clip should be measured in centimeter or inches, not yard or kilometers or miles. Nobody measures the length of a clip in miles. Do you understand? This is insane. We do not measure the length of a clip in terms of meter. Let's look at answer choice C. Answer choice C says liter. What's wrong with liter? Well, there are many things wrong with liter. Well, actually, one thing only. Meter, or rather liter, is a measure of liquid. It's a unit that is used to measure the amount of liquid. Measuring the length, trying to measure the length of a clip in terms of gallons is just as insane. Gallons are used for liquid measurement. One liter is about 1/4 of a gallon. If you don't know how much a liter is, if you cannot conceptualize this, you know what a gallon is. We go to gas station all the time to fill up our tank. You know how many gallons of gas you put in your car. Well, 1 liter is not even a gallon, it's 1/4 of a gallon. But that's not the point here. The point here is not that it's less than 1/4 of a gallon. The bloody point here is that the liter is used for liquid. We do not use liter to measure the length of something like a paperclip. Not unless we have already told our relatives and family members to guess ourselves a nice straitjacket for Christmas. Same thing with the D. Milliliter. Milliliter is 1/1000 of a liter. Liter is a measure of is a unit to measure liquid. Similarly, milliliter is simply a measure to use liquid also. The answer is B. B says millimeter. Now meter is about a yard, as we just said before, right here. Meter is about a yard. A meter is about 39 inches. A yard is 36 inches. Meter a yard, but we're not using meter to measure the length. We're using millimeter, 1/1000th of a meter. And that will be quite okay to measure the length of a clip in millimeter, or even if you like, centimeter. 1,000 millimeter becomes 1 meter. So this unit is 1/1000th of that guy. The answer is B. Let's look at 4. Some of the problems are bizarre. Number 4. It says, which is best approximation by a kilogram? And before we get into the 4 choices that are given to us, in other words, we're going to measure something and we are going to measure it using the unit of kilogram. And the question is, are the four answer choices that we have, which one would be an appropriate thing that we will use a kilogram on to measure is, measure that thing, whatever it is. Let's see what a kilogram is. A kilogram, which is abbreviated as kg, is approximately 2 pounds. Or if you want to be a little bit more precise, a kilogram is approximately 2.2 pounds. In other words, 1 pound, and of course you can picture very easily how much is 1 pound. 1 pound is about half a kilogram. 1 pound is a little over half a kilogram. Let's take a look at it. So the question is, what would you measure? What is it out of the four answer choices that we have? What could be an appropriate thing that we can, would be a thing where you would measure its weight in a pound? If you don't like kilogram, think of it pound, because pound is simply half a kilogram. Let's see. First one is a tablet. A tablet as in tablet that you and I take as a medicine, that tablet. Not the guy who was carrying on his shoulder the other day. A tablet. Would you try to measure the weight of a tablet in terms of kilogram, in terms of pounds? No, it's too light. This thing is too light. If you wanted to measure the weight of a tablet, you would measure it in terms of grams. The next one is a piece of paper. Would you try to measure the weight of a paper, piece of paper, in terms of pounds or kilograms? No, it's too light again. Same reason, it's too light. Here's the next one, which is even more insane. Answer choice B says, it's spilled water. Well, first of all, the water is a liquid. You will use some measurement unit of measurement for liquid, such as liter or ounces or gallons, something like that. Not kilograms and pounds. If you had a cup of water, I suppose you could measure the weight of the cup of water, but this bloody thing is spilled. As I said, the bloody thing is spilled. How are you going to measure the weight of it? To say nothing of the fact that it is liquid. The answer here is A. I'm making too much fuss about it. Rabbit. The weight of a rabbit would be an appropriate thing where you would use a kilogram. And you will probably tell me that my rabbit weighs 2 kilograms. And if your rabbit weighs 2 kilograms, it weighs about 4 pounds. Seems logical. Let's look at 5. Question number 5, the last one. It says, which is closest to 873.5 times 4.72 over 59.6. And here are the answer choices. 75,000, or rather, yeah, 75,000 over 7,500 over 750 or 75. Those are your answer choices. When we are trying to estimate this quantity, which one of these is closest to this quantity? Let's see what we can do, shall we? 873, if you look at the scale from 800 to 900, 850 is right here. We are way past halfway mark to the right. It's more than 873 is more than 850. So a good way to estimate 873, if you want to make a quick calculation, would be 900. In other words, 873 is approximately 900. Similarly, 5.72, that's more than 4.72, that's more than 4.5, that's more than 4.5. It's much closer to 5. When you're rounding it, good approximation would be 5. Similarly, this guy we can clearly see, 59.6, is very close to 60. And let's see what we can do. Divide top and bottom by 10. Divide top and bottom by 10. 0 is going to drop out. We have a 90 and we have a 6. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. When we divide top and bottom by 3, 6 divided by 3 is 2. And 90 divided by 3 would be 30. So what we end up on the top is 30 times 5, which is 150. And at the bottom we end up at 2. 150 divided by 2, we end up with 75. This quantity, the closest, which is the closest to this quantity, the closest approximation of this quantity, the closest approximation of this quantity, out of these 5 is 75. We'll call it a day now, okay? We'll meet again tomorrow. Bye now.